Eduardo Mortara against Mike Rockefeller, Bruno Spengler against Renga van der Zande. These duels are the semi-finals of the DTM show event in the Olympic Stadium Munich. The battle is on for the participation in the final qualifying round. In fascinating brand eternal knockout heats, the four DTM drivers prevailed at the challenging 1.2 kilometers long track.
I enjoyed it here especially because it's really hard. If you do a little mistake, you directly break your car in the walls, and that's really tough on this track, and I think it's really hard for everybody, but I'm really happy that I'm in the half final now.
I raced with Mattia was unbelievable, so close, and we managed to win it. I don't know honestly how we did it, because he's so good in these tracks.
DTM stalwarts Gary Paffett and Martin Tomczyk were already sidelined after the round of the last 16. Paffett lost his round against DTM rookie Renga van der Zande after having misjudged one of the tight corners.
It's disappointing. I wanted to go quite far, and the car, and I've been pretty fast actually, so it's disappointing, but Renga did a good job. So.
With his experience from the Race of Champions, David Coulthard also provided excitement in the round of the last 16.
Well, I jumped the start, and then I knew I just had to go as fast as I could to gain the 2 seconds penalty. So in the end, it was enough, and we go through to the next round.
In the quarterfinals, David Coulthard was then beaten by the surprisingly strong Renga van der Zande. Another surprise was Matthias Ekström's defeat. He also lost out against a DTM rookie, Eduardo Mortara. Disappointment for Matthias Ekström, who was considered as one of the favorites.
I had one mistake in turn one on the second lane, and then the pit stop was a bit slower, and that was it. And Eduardo, he did a spotless drive, so I think he will have a good chance to be quickest today.
Who claims victory, and what will the duels for the finals on Sunday will be like? The qualifying results at DTM TV.